Lovkins people had said a while ago that you guys sat down with HBO and they said, yeah, we want the fight.
Man, no disrespect, bro, but it's not about Golovkin right now. It's not about him. I'm not trying to be disrespectful, but they've done too much talking. You know what I'm saying? Like, they've done a lot of talking and we haven't responded intentionally. And it's just not, you know, when he fights, it's about him, but it's not about him right now. He had his opportunity, he didn't take it, and, you know, we're moving on. I wish him nothing but the best.
Andre, you haven't lost since you were 12. How do you keep that focus every day, every time you step into the ring? Because 1 second I'm not paying attention and...
I just hate to lose, man. I hate it. I hate to lose at anything. And I'm a poor loser, too. I just hate to lose. Like, I don't want to lose in cards. I don't want to lose in board games. I just don't want to lose. So, I don't know. I think that's got a lot to do with it. But, you know, I just try to... Man, I don't know. You know, I don't know. I've really not even tried to like keep my mind focused on the streak. I really don't think about it at all until it's brought up. I just try to, you know. God has blessed me with a work ethic, man, and you know, it was cultivated as I was a young kid growing up. But it was just this drive was in me to be the best and to try to, you know, just give it all I got. And I'm still like that, thankfully, at 32 years old. It's just I go in the gym and I try to max out, and I need my team to tell me, no, you're not going 12 rounds a day, you're only going 6. Okay, no, just you're not running 6 miles, just run 3. And as long as I got that mentality, I think good things will keep happening. You know, but when I feel like I can't put out like that anymore, then, you know, it's probably time to walk away.
Andre, how do you plan on spending your economic?
Man, I'm gonna probably be in the bed with my wife, chilling. My kids are just running around. We're probably not gonna do much. We're just gonna just relax and just. I haven't been home, you know. I haven't been home. I've been in training camp, and that's part of my job, and that's the part that I hate the most is not the training, but just leaving my kids and my wife and not being a part of their life for 6-8 weeks, you know. But it pays off. I was able to get mama that check tonight. You know, so she had me. And, you know,
we had
the inconsistencies and stuff and the layoffs. Like, we haven't made a, you know, a good deposit like that in a while. So,
Warriors
I'm looking forward
back
to
back.
It.
Don't worry
your
about
defense
it.
Looked real good. And he tried to throw her, tried to bully you on the ropes. And you were just slipping and moving. How did you feel physically? Did you feel loose?
I felt pretty good with that. But the next step is, like, making him pay. You know, that's the part, like, even in my mind, I'm like, man, okay, man, he missed, now I gotta make him pay, and that's what Virg was calling for. And it's just, those are the things I'm talking about when I say maybe a B or a B minus. You know, it was a good performance, but in my mind, it wasn't the kind of performance that I feel like I can be satisfied with.
And then at the Kovalev roundtable earlier today, Kathy Duva said that this would be an HBO pay-per-view fight when you meet up with Kovalev. If you guys stay winning, you think you're ready for HBO pay-per-view?
Oh, yeah. Been 10 years. It's time.
Hey, last question.
How was the crowd from inside the ring? It was a pretty live atmosphere. I'm kind of interested in your perspective of how the crowd is reacting.
Man, it's great. It's I hear them, you know, I do. I hear them, I hear the chants. And it's tricky because fighting home, man, you gotta be, people think it's a given. Like, oh, you're fighting home, it's easy. It's like, no, it's harder. I'm walking to the ring, I'm seeing cousins and uncles and friends, and I'm like, man, but I gotta actually stay in the moment, and I can't get caught up. I gotta go perform. So I'm trying to make all these people, I'm trying to send everybody home happy. So even when they chant your name, part of you wants to step on the gas, but it may not be time to step on the gas. So it's just, it's tricky, it's a fine line when you're fighting at home, but at the end of the day, you know, you wanna get that good performance and you wanna get that win, and like I said, send everybody home happy.
Kovalev then next, or you want one more and then Kovalev?
Yeah, I gotta let my team work that out, you know.
Do you feel based on what you graded your performance that you would like one
I
more?
I think another fight is in order.
Yeah.
I would say so.
You know, Have you learned anything from the champions that you had in the ring with you, like Draymond and Steph and, you know, like
Don't do that.
You want me to answer that?
No, that's terrible. That's ridiculous.
I ain't gonna answer it. I don't want to make the big man mad.
Can I ask you a nice, a good, heartfelt question to end it?
How did it feel to have your open media day at King's Gym? Did that mean something special to you?
Yeah, it's I actually started at a small gym in Hayward. That's where I first walked into a gym. That's where I first met Virgil. First time I got punched in the face. All of those first times were in that gym. And then as I started to get better, we needed better competition. I went to King's when I was probably maybe 11 or 12. And have been there ever since. And then, you know, a couple years ago, we got our own gym. But to be able to, like, bring this type of event back to King's and you know, something of that magnitude is always a blessing. I mean, they still got posters up from 2004. So that shows you the kind of respect and appreciation they have for myself and my team. So it's always special. It's always special. And the thing is this, like, you know, I can't apologize for fighting at home. You know, I've had 29 fights and I fought at home maybe 8 times. You know, and of course we want to venture out and fight other places, you know, Vegas, New York, but when I do get the opportunity to fight at home and, you know, network or whoever wants to bring it here, man, I got to enjoy it. You know, I got to enjoy it because again, I'm not going to always be able to do this. So when I can do it, man, I want to definitely appreciate it.
Yeah,